Playing first is very important with this kind of decks, and then it's great. I'm gonna keep it. Now I can either play Polluted Delta, fetch for Steam Vents and tap, and play Delver Secrets. That way, I will definitely have to fetch them next turn to play Serum Visions. And also, you know, reducing the odds of drawing Steam Vents is always a nice thing. And as I said, I have to fetch my next turn, so might as well do it now. So let's do it. We're looking for, I guess, Thought Scour would be very good because it makes me play a turn... Turn 3 Tazigar. If I draw Thought Scour, I will not be able to... In order to play turn 2 Tazigar, you have to play turn 1 Thought Scour. But we are going to play Delver, which is of course better. Also, our opponent is making this video a little bit annoying. Okay. Delver's in the house. Let's see how our opponent's gonna respond to that. Usually, I record a little bit in prior videos. So this is actually the day after Kevin Jones won the tournament. So maybe, you know, there could be more of this kind of deck around since people want to try it out. Oh, instead we are against Dredge. Fateless Looting, so it means that I will not play Thought Scour on my opponent. I never played against Dredge. I know it has been very good lately with the Neonate and this prized amalgamum. What's left from the loam? Okay, let's see if we flip it. Yes, very good. Remand. So here we can either play Serum Visions or just play Remand on whatever it goes for. Which is possible. I wanna do that. The thing is that I have Spellsnare to draw, Thought Scour, Bolt, but if I don't draw like those, my turn is kinda wasted. Yeah, but my opponent knows I have Remand, so I might just pass the turn. And just flash as Snapcaster Mage end of turn if thing doesn't go, if he play doesn't play any spell. Yeah. It's not the best, but I assume that I have to pressure my opponent a lot and assume that he doesn't have any ways to answer the Insect Elaboration. Maybe just Stink with Imp. Okay, Conflagrate might be an answer for that, but he needs just another land. Yeah, but I have Remand. This is a sorcery, so... Okay, he played that, and I think I might just Remand this. I might not find enough time. Like, if he only plays Neonate this turn. He had another land for it. Okay. He's just going to dredge it right away. Maybe hoping to find some Narcomoebas to reanimate his prized amalgamum. Oof. We could have hit a Delver last turn if we played our Serum Visions. That's kind of unfortunate. So we're gonna play Serum Visions now and then play Delver. Bold Thought Scour. Both those cards are very good. Thought Scour makes me play Thazigar, but Bold just goes upstairs. I think I like both, but probably I'm just going to shuffle some of those away at some point. He's already at 10. Next turn I'm gonna beat him down for 6, down to 4, and then I have Bolt. So if my opponent takes any damage, yeah, Narcomoeba, but still he doesn't have any bridge from below in the graveyard. He also has a Blood Gust. Oh, he conflagrate this divided damage, right? Oh, I forgot about that. So I can just kill both of my Delvers here. This was a huge misplay. Yeah, when you're not used to play against these cards. I thought this was only damage to one creatures instead of both. So maybe I should have held my Delver. Yeah, it's definitely going for the conflict right here. Discarding three cards, whatever. Yep. And also, I'm not. Yeah, no, I can't play Thazigar even in. Yes. It's kind of bad now. He's a 3/3. We're gonna ever Thazigar. I can also just Dreadboard and Arcomoebas. Or. Yeah, there's a Thaskar on top that I like. It's fine, but nothing special. And also, I wanna have a right timing for my plays. So I'm gonna get a swamp, I think. It's not great, but let me play the Thazigar plus Dreadboar. I'll delve everything but remand and play Dreadboar. Yeah, remanding the neonate wasn't great, but you can't just held the remand for the rest of the game. This is a, oh, it chose to went for the faithless looting, which is totally reasonable. Still doesn't find any like dredge six card or bridge from below. I did find his third Narcomoeba. Alright, I just blocked that because it will not come back into play. And while this Bloodgust can come back if he had a land in the end. Okay, so what to do now? I can play Lightning Bolt on the Narcomoeba and then Mana Leak the Faithless Looting. Yeah, that's a. I can also just attack, but it's gonna block. So Lightning Bolt. Even if can go upstairs, I think it's fine to play now. Because it's a cheap interaction. Don't let me hold the mana leak. So put him down to 6 and I'm up to 10, but I have an Upcaster Bolt next turn. So if he actually doesn't find any more creatures, I can just attack for 4 and snap Bolt. Alright, so he dredged but didn't find. I mean, he ran out of Narcomoeba, so he can't find any of those. Life from the Loam. Getting back 3 fetches. I don't care about this, right? Oh, he might have. What's the name? Dried Arbor, but I assume he doesn't, so. I just let this resolve. It's probably a bait. So he has 3 lands and a card. Oh, okay. He just wanted to reanimate Bloodgust, but that thing doesn't block and this thing comes to play top, right? Yeah. Okay. Yes. Okay. I'll attack. And then I have Snap Bolt ready. Alright, we managed to win the game, even if could have been way easier. But it's fine. So we don't have any graveyard aid actually. Which I don't know if it's correct nowadays with so many dredge thing out, but I don't even know what to play. Oh yeah, maybe you can play Rakdos Charm to exile the graveyard. Other than that, we have definitely Magma Spray. And maybe that's it. Remand actually is not the worst with the flashback cards. I don't know. Vanilla Click seems great because it flies. All those creatures seems great because... I don't know, they're just great. Electrolyze maybe it's the worst along with Call and Command. They are kind of expensive and they don't really do that much. I don't know about Dispel. Might board out, board in something that's worth dispelling. Maybe, maybe not. I think I will board out the Dreadbolt for Explosives Engineer. It might have with the Bridge from Below. Wait, I don't even know if it's legal, Bridge from Below. Maybe it's not legal. Wait, let me check. Yes, it is legal. It's a Dread Return, which is banned, so my opponent would just not like it to not find it. I think Engineer Explosive is fine. Let's go this way. Opponent went up to 62 cards, but sideboard, maybe. He want to not die. From deck, no one adapt deck himself. Let's see. There's actually the dredge deck is like this game would have been way like my opponent dredged even just one Bridge from Below, it would have been a lot of damage just coming through because we actually killed at least two Narcomoebas. Alright, this is the kind of hand that I think is a keep. We have cantrips, one lander. Also, Serum Visions look through a lot of cards, so I think it's worth keeping it. Alright. We instantly found a Steam Vent. Our opponent didn't play one drop, which is definitely good. I will... I think I play... I take Watery Gravier. I don't think this deck needs to be... Oh, wait. Wait, I'm gonna place a land kill Wimby as a 2-drop that I wanna counter it. Yes, I should have. Alright, let's take this. Take 2 damage and pass. Having Thought Scour means that I can play Spellsnare or Thought Scour. I shouldn't do that. This is... First time playing with the deck, so, you know. You... Don't see some lines instantly. Okay, 2 mana something. So Left from the Loom, maybe Tormenting Voice. Yes, great. Spellsnare. It's also a play that might be a bluff. You know, sometimes you just fetch on top land, go, and it's a bluff. Alright. Delver Secrets, maybe best draw possible. And keep doing that. Just passing the turn here. My opponent wanna cast another Tormenting Voice. I have a Spellsnare. If he doesn't, then I just Tothgower. Tothgower Delver, it's a little interesting because you can... Okay, it doesn't do anything. You can just look at top card and mill it if it's bad, but here I'm constricted mana, so I don't care about that. Alright, land, it's not what I wanted. Yeah, I have to fetch for, I think, a mountain. Yeah, go get a mountain. And I'll play Serum Visions. Unfortunately, I cannot, I think I'll bottom both, since I can't flip the Delver. Hence, I will mill my top 2 cards there. Blasting Mar was probably the worst fetch land among the three, because like I would have loved to have an island here, but I can't go that deep on land. Okay, so you have a Narcomoeba here. But I can't have a land because it just passed last turn. So here I can either play Terminate of the Narcomoeba or Tuscour. No. Maybe Terminate sounds better. And also, as I said, I can make the Tuscour play here. Magma Spray. Yes, I want to reveal it. And I want to also draw it. Unfortunately, I don't have any bolt in my graveyard. I can go for the Snapcaster, what's the name? Snapcaster spell Serum Visions play, but I think I likely just pass the turn again. Maybe end of turn go Snapcaster to Tuscour. My opponent doesn't do anything relevant. Opponent is kinda in a bad situation because if he dredge. So he dredged. What did he dredge? He did dredge only 3, right? Drachmor Savage, yeah. Okay. So Drachmor Savage means that he has a turn 3 play next turn. Here I can play. What I can play? Terminate Tothgower. I think it's what I'm going to play. Let's terminate this. Maybe Tothgower first. Tothgower first. Okay, Vendilion Monolith. And then terminate that. I want to draw land to have Snapcaster remand. I did. Good. So keep beating down, putting it down to 12. And I'll pass. Ready to... okay, Conflagrate is in the graveyard now. Is it ready to Snapcaster Mana Leak the Faithless Sleuthing? So Conflagrate here means that if I go Snapcaster Mana Leak, for the next turn can kill both of my Insect Elaboration and Snapcaster. But actually, Conflagrate, what's the converted mana cost? It's a lot, right? Yeah. It's gonna be like 13, stuff like that. Because it's actually, it's like Entry the Angels. If you Miracle Entry the Angels, then the mana cost is very high. Hopefully my opponent goes for Conflagrate now. Because if he just goes for Faithless Looting, then I know what to do. I think I have to Snapcaster Remand and hope to draw another counter magic for the Conflagrate. Let's see, okay, Conflagrate. X equals 7, he's got his old land. Jeez, there's another Conflagrate. He has 2 Blood Gusts. Yeah. Let's go for Snapcaster Remand, attack for 5. And then it's gonna be hard. Because it means that I need to draw another removal spell for Conflagrate. Mana Leak, great. Sorry, removal spell, cantrips, counter. Great stuff. So yeah, attack for 7, put the opponent down to 5, which is very low life. And then having this Mana Leak means that I can't even cast this Serum Visions, I think. Yeah, draw Mana Leak again. Let's see, he parallel mills 6 here. I found a Narco Moeba, but we have this this removal spell for it. You also have Pressed Magma, but that doesn't do anything right now. Yeah, so I think we have this game locked. Locked up. Let's go second Magnificent passes. Wait, what? Oh, now to the bone. Okay, but we have this Mana Leak ready, so I just Magma Sprite that. And our opponent goes for the Now to the Bone, we're gonna Mana Leak that, so. We have a win here. I don't know what happened, I just miscounted something. I thought I was at 12, I attacked for 5, then 5. Oh yeah, I thought I was attacking for 7 for some reason. Okay, whatever. Luckily, topping the Mana Leak means that I have another interaction for Conflagrate, which of course was very lucky. Yeah, I guess I passed the turn here. I don't know what happened. Yeah, I probably just, thought there were different life total, or maybe just miscounted. By the way, my opponent here has a Golgari Grave Troll, and if he dredges whatever dredges. Maybe not. If he dredges. Yeah, I don't even know what he dredged here. What did he dredge? Stinkweed Imp. So if he casts either Stinkweed Imp or Conflagrate, I just got to mana leak that and it's gonna be gay. But it's kinda, you know. Not good to show that I just don't know the math. But that's fine. Alright, Conflagrate. I'm going to. So the equal cost is 5 probably. Oh yeah, last turn it couldn't conflagrate because you need to discard card and didn't have any. Okay, that's how that card worked, yeah. So basically last turn you needed to hit the Ignite of the Bone to survive. Maybe he shouldn't have discarded 7 cards with this first conflagrate because he had another conflagrate in his hand. Yeah, I wasn't that prepared for this match. Like, I didn't know exactly what his card did. But overall, you know, this is Delver's strategy is just forward, just straightforward. You just play your beaters, your counter magic, and your bolts, and you just win the game, even if you don't exactly know how what is going on. You know, Modern is such a vast format that knowing everything is so difficult. And yeah, so this was the match. So let's go there.